Some yacht videos that we publish worry me that maybe we can't quite convey how beautiful and how unique the yacht is. This is one such video. It's taken my appreciation of classic yachts to a higher level. Nordic Star was built in 1969 by the Lantana shipyard in Florida, commissioned for a very wealthy and prominent family in Newport Beach in California. And in fact, as soon as she was launched, she came all the way around to Newport Beach, which is where she's been ever since. Now, she's passed through the hands of three prominent families in the Newport Beach area who've all enjoyed cruising with her quite extensively, regularly, even up as far as Alaska. Eventually, she was donated to the Orange County College for Sailors and Seamanship, who used her for training many of their students. And actually, we'll come back to the contribution that the college made to the yacht in a few moments. But first of all, let's take a look at her vital statistics. Nordic Star is a classic motor yacht that has an overall length of 92 feet and a beam of 22 feet. Built entirely from aluminium, she can cruise at 10 knots and has a top speed of about 13 knots. Her range at 10 knots is about 3,000 nautical miles. All of this delivered by two Caterpillar D43 engines generating 465 horsepower each. The yacht has been constantly updated, including a new air conditioning system in 2018. Well, the layout of the yacht is really quite unusual, as you can see. I'm not aware of anything on the market being built right now with a layout quite like this. We have a huge boat deck currently occupied by these two big tenders, although you could actually fit even bigger tenders on here as long as they can be handled by this central 2,000-pound crane. Moving further aft, we have a Portuguese bridge, which is great for access to the bow, but also on either side, look at this, we have the mooring stations here. So this is just a great position from which you can see easily all the way down the side of the yacht. It makes docking just so much more comfortable. Very small aft deck, but once again, another docking station facing the stern. So really for a yacht that's 92 feet, it's a very manageable vessel and a very owner-operator styled vessel, as you'll see as we'll look around. In fact, the aft deck leads directly into the bridge. And most of the instrumentation that you can see here was renewed in 2014, 2015, so it really is very modern instruments for the navigation. These stairs take us directly down to the main aft deck. And this is actually a beautiful area with these two separate tables. I would imagine this is where most of the guests on board are going to enjoy eating al fresco, although there's a hidden surprise down here because the yacht has a cockpit too, which would just be great for fishing off in the back of, or just sunbathing. Well, of course, great access to the sea if you want to take a dip, although I think the water's a little bit cold here, just off of the coast of California today. Let's take a look inside the yacht, because the layout there is equally unusual, and I think you will be amazed at the work that the college did on the interiors. So So when the college received the yacht as a donation, one of the first things that they did was to completely redesign and build this interior that you can see around you here. It's absolutely gorgeous. I spoke to the broker who's representing this yacht, and he was telling me that he visited while the work was being done and the interior was completely gutted, and he put his head in his hands and said, "What have you done to this yacht?" But when it was finished, he, like everybody else, it's just jaw-droppingly beautiful. They've remained so true to the original nautical style of the yacht. The colors, the textures, the fabrics that they've used are absolutely beautiful. I particularly like, just behind Max, this teak paneling on the walls here. It just reminds you of an old pirate ship or ships from days gone by. And what a wonderful area to be able to enjoy dining inside the vessel. We'll be looking beyond that bulkhead in a few moments, but first, let's take a look at the cabins. All of the accommodation is below deck, and just take a look at this. Beautiful twin beds here in a fantastic setting. Now, like anybody else, I love seeing super yachts with unusual fabrics and stones and ceramics and all kinds of different things. It's beautiful, but there's also a beauty to this simplicity of design here that stays so true to the original theme of yachts back in the 1960s and the 1970s. The ensuite bathroom is just so clean, clear lines, lovely marble, lovely varnished teak wood. What a fantastic yacht to be able to host your friends on board. Let's take a look as well at the owner's stateroom. Any modern yacht builder would be absolutely proud to be able to present something like this. It is comfortable, sumptuous, cozy, beautiful bathroom again through here, again with that lovely white marble, and a very large shower room as well. I just cannot imagine what more you would want out of a 92-foot yacht than this. Let's take a look now at some of the working areas on board, the galley and the crew quarters, to see how they stack up. So the galley is forward, and by having just three staterooms for guests on the yacht, of course, you give a lot of extra space in this forward area. And it's a huge galley, really, for a 92-foot yacht. I like the fact they've used stainless steel here. It feels very clean and restaurant style. I like the fact that they've got good high-end appliances, a nice large fridge. You can just imagine that if you buy this yacht and you do take your family up to Alaska or wherever it wants to go, you will not want to get off the yacht and go to shore. You'll just be very happy to be able to get the cooking done in here, eat outside, and watch the world go by. You will probably need crew though. So let's take a look at the crew quarters. So the crew quarters weren't subject to that restoration work that I spoke about earlier. The wood that you can see here is the same wood that the entire yacht was decked in prior to the restoration. It's a big crew quarters. You've got a large washer and a large dryer here, comfortable seating areas, a dinette, and of course the cabins are through here. Crew cabins we have on the starboard side, one cabin with one bunk. Forward, another cabin with three bunks. And then a very spacious bathroom here to port. As I said at the beginning of this video, I was really worried that we wouldn't do justice to the yacht through the video, I felt that there was so much that I wanted to say about the vessel, but really so little to say. It just is a beautiful yacht that you have to experience. You have to come on board to fully appreciate what a charismatic ambience that the yacht creates. I do hope though that through the images that we've brought to you, you get some sensation for what an incredible charismatic vessel this is. I also hope that the video leads somebody to be able to show her the love and care that she needs in future years. And she certainly has many, many more years ahead of her. If you feel you may be that person, please do contact us at the email address shown on screen now.